Hi there, my name is Dan. Now there are loads of videos here like this one on my channel, but if you want more, check out my website, bringyourownlaptop.com. Hi there. In this video, we're going to create a lower thirds title overlay. So people call it lower thirds, titles, any sort of kind of bit of text that appears at the bottom of the screen explaining. Generally, you have a talking head and you want to explain who they are. Okay, kind of set the scene, what they are, what their credentials are, who we're talking to or listening to at least. Okay, to do it, we've got this old program open, project open. I need a new one. So I just want to let you know, you save it, you go file, and you can go to close project. Okay, and remember, we get given an untitled project to get started for our next project. All right, so first thing we need to do is create a composition. So instead of going to a new composition, we're going to let the video create it. So we're gonna import video, and I'm gonna give you your first bit of sneaky shortcut awesomeness. Is, can you see in the project window, this big empty area here? If you double click it, it goes to import. Awesome, eh? Okay, so instead of going to file, import file, you just double click in there, nice. Okay, there's one in here called talkinghead.mp4. Bring that in. So I've got this mp4. You can double click it to preview it. Okay, this is not a composition, it's just kind of giving you your little preview. Hit spacebar.
Hi, my name is Dan.
It's me talking to myself. Okay, so what we can do to make a comp from it is right click it, new comp from selection. Okay, and we've got this thing called talking head. You could rename it now by right clicking it. Talking head works for me. All right, I'm gonna save this project and I'm gonna stick it on our desktop. And where do you stick it? I'm sticking it in this one here, I'm sticking mine somewhere else. I'm sticking mine in here. You can put yours on your desktop. I'm putting mine in these production files here. Mainly, I talked about them earlier, just so that you, if you get lost, you can use my files, right? So this one here is called 15. Here we go, great. So next thing I need to do is, there's me playing, running
Hi,
through. I'm gonna turn the audio down, A, because I hate listening to myself talk, and you need to be able to hear me talk weird. But can you see over here this little mute button? Okay, with it on, I can hear stuff. With it off, it's just me talking. Okay, you gotta make sure you turn it back on when you go to export, because otherwise it won't export audio. Okay, so I'm gonna bring my playhead back to the beginning, and what I'd like to do is kind of like a white box to slide out over here. Okay, or maybe just appear and then type to slide into it and then it all to disappear a little bit later. So we're gonna do a couple of bits of animation and it's really just the same sorts of things we did for our first text animation, slightly different, but keyframing, adding some motion blur and some easing. So first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna grab this thing here called the rectangle tool. Now the rectangle tool is a crazy one. If you're self-taught and you start doing this, watch. Weirdly, it becomes a mask. Okay, you just want a rectangle, I just want a white box. So I'm gonna undo. Okay, undo is under edit. There's one called undo. Okay, and all right, so I've gone back to it's fine. What you need to do is grab your black arrow and just click off in here so you've got no layers selected. Okay, so if I have no layers selected here and I use the exact same tool, okay, it will go through and draw a rectangle. It's a red one, it's not what I want. Okay, so just make sure you have nothing selected down here. All right, let's give it a fill color. I'm gonna move white. And in terms of the stroke around the outside, because it's a white stroke, you're not gonna see it, but I'm gonna get rid of it just by turning it to zero. Oh, click in here, type zero. Or you can click in here, nope, type zero. All right, and I'm gonna draw in a box. It's gonna be kind of like that sort of size. And I want it to appear over the side here, and I'm gonna put some type. I'm gonna put Daniel Scott, After Effects Trainer, or something like that. Okay, so first thing I need to do is gonna grab my black arrow, and we're gonna set up some keyframes. So what I'd like it to do is actually play for a little while before this thing even starts to play up here. To get it to start later on, okay, at the moment it starts right at the beginning here. So I'm gonna start it about here, maybe after a second or two. And watch this, I can drag this guy along, okay, just so that it doesn't exist. You can see this gap here now, and it exists from then on. Okay, it just kind of appears at the moment. I've hit a little shortcut. I'm gonna leave it in there because I accidentally hit it. I hit the N key on my keyboard. N key is a shortcut, which is really good when you know what you're doing, but if you don't, and it starts doing this, okay, you get that error. Okay, if you get that error, it means that you've hit the N key accidentally. All it means is that that might be your problem. Okay, is this called the work area? We'll talk about him later on, but if you accidentally get this really small, it comes up with errors, and you just need to extend that out to be the whole animation, and you should be away again. All right. Not my smoothest tutorial by far, but we've worked out a few little problems here. So we've got them along. What I'd like to do is I'd like to play around with the opacity. So I want this to kind of fade in. To do it, I want my playhead to be right at the beginning here. And watch this. It's not very clever. It doesn't snap to the beginning, right? So it's not hard to get to the beginning here, but a nice little thing you can do is while you're dragging your playhead or your CTI, okay, is you can drag it along, and if you hold shift on your keyboard, watch mine. If I hold shift, drag, watch when it gets close, it just launched out there and snaps to the edge. So it's really kind of cool little shortcut. Two shortcuts in one video. Awesome. Okay, so I'm at the beginning. What I'd like to do is play with the opacity. So along here, there's a bunch of things hanging out at the bottom of the shape layer. Let's call this one. Let's double click the word. What am I doing? Let's right click it and go to rename. Okay, and let's call this one, instead of shape layer, let's call this one lower third background. Great. And under transform, okay, I want to go down to opacity, and we're going to set the little stopwatch going again. So it's like waiting, click, and now it's recording what I do. And I'm going to turn the opacity down to zero. So it's completely gone. Then after a little while, how long? I'm not too sure yet. Maybe, I don't know, half a second, something like that. You can drag these icons around afterwards. Is turn the opacity up to 100%. Now, if you're following along, you can always keep an eye on this. If I say about half a second, you can see I've actually put it at, it's at 1 second and 16 frames. So you could type that in here by going like this. And a cool little trick is you can just go 1, 1, 6, and it will kind of put in the colons and everything for you. All right, so starts at zero, goes up to 100%. Pull my playhead back, spacebar, and I'm happy with that timing, it's fine. If you're not happy with it, you can drag it further apart, make it go slower. Watch this, spacebar, slowly comes on. Okay, and if you want to be faster, you can bring them together, and they go a bit faster. That looks for me. All right, so once that, now I want type to slide in. Okay, so I'd like to, you can see if I twirl this up, and I twirl that up, I've got two layers. Okay, there's my video on behind, there's my lower third, kind of background. Now I'm going to grab my type tool, okay, and I'm going to click once here, and I'm going to type in Daniel Walter Scott. Okay, select it all, pick a font. Okay, if you can't see your fonts, so look at this character one here. I shrunk mine down when I was dealing with this preview. If you can't find yours anywhere, go to Window Character. All right, and font size, I'm going to drag this down so it fits. I'm going to make it a color I can see. I'm going to click black from there. Okay, grab my black arrow to move it around. So it's gonna kind of end up here. I'm not gonna worry about it too much because I'm gonna end up change this. And what I might do is double click it, go jumps to the type tool, put a return in, and I am the founder of, I have to use BYOL because it's just too damn long. Bring your own laptop. So I'm just gonna shrink that down. Okay, might use that as the bold. I might use that as the light version. There you go. Okay, you can spend ages on fonts. I'd like to, but I need to get on with this tutorial. Okay, I'm gonna go to fit as well. Okay, the reason it's all pixelated as well, why is it all pixelated? Did you guess? It's because of this. It'll export fine, but previewing it here, it's set to quarter, so I'm gonna set it to full because I really wanna see my lovely preview. Ah, another good error. See this red thing down the bottom here? It says disabled and it all goes black. Okay, it means because I got my caps lock on. Because a second ago I was typing in uppercase, I had my caps lock on my keyboard on. I'm gonna turn caps lock off and magically it comes back. Okay, so if you ever have the problem of that, okay, where it goes blank and a little red bar at the bottom, it's because you've left caps lock on your keyboard. Okay, I've had people reinstall After Effects trying to get rid of that thing and it turns out caps lock was on for the whole afternoon. Okay, so I've got this, I've got that. What I want to do is start animating it now. So where, I'm gonna hit spacebar, that appears. And my type here, just like this other one, I want it to start a little bit later. So instead of starting like right at the beginning here, I'm gonna get it to start about there. So roughly, hold shift to get it to playhead. So if you're following me, mine's at 119. Okay, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start it off screen. So grab my black arrow, you my friend, hold shift to get it to go straight, get off. Get over there, you might have to zoom out a little bit. Go back to 50%, so you can see the side here. Okay, we're gonna set our first keyframe and it's for position. So twirl it down, transform, set the stopwatch going. So it's gonna set a little keyframe right there off screen. A little bit long. Okay, how far is a little? I've got mine at 2 seconds, 2 frames, and I'm gonna hold shift and I think you need to start dragging, then hold shift, rather than shift to start with. So start dragging and pulling, then hold shift, and it will get it in a straight line. Cool, so I'm gonna drive back, preview, me talking. If this happens, can you see it's only kind of buffering and only getting to here? So it gets to the green thing and loop around. It's because I accidentally hit spacebar twice. So I might have to bring it back here, hit spacebar. If you hit spacebar twice, it kind of tries to loop back on itself. So if you ever get stuck in that eternal loop, just drag the playhead out again, hit spacebar again, and it should be fine. There he goes. Okay, it's a bit fast, so I'm gonna open it up a little bit. Back to here. Okay, so it's sliding on, but it's missing the magic. We learned the magic in an earlier video. There's two of them. There's easing and there is motion blur. The reason I'm not doing motion blur and easing to the fade of the lower third, the white box, is because I find when you do fades is that you can mess around with easing all day and the motion blur all day and it makes no difference. There'll be purists out there that will not agree, but I figure it's just not worth it. I can't see any difference with easing with things fading in and out. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'd like to play around with these two guys now. To do the easing, it's easiest just to grab both of them. It depends what you wanna do. I'm gonna get mine to ease both sides. You could just do one, so it kind of starts fast and ends slow. Okay, I'm gonna do both of them because I like the look of that. Right click, keyframe velocity, 70, 70, drag it back, hit spacebar, and still a little fast. So it's kind of smoother, but I'm gonna open it out a little bit. Yeah, it looks nice. Now, another magic, so that's the easing, first step in awesomeness. The second step is motion blur. Okay, remember you turn it on globally, and then you forget, and you hit play, and nothing happens. Okay, what do you have to do? Remember, you have to go through and turn it on globally, but also for the layer, this particular layer. Okay, I'm gonna tool this down to make it look nice. You could turn it on for this one as well, and this one. It's not gonna do anything. Well, I think you can't see it at least. Okay, so here we go, slide, blurry when it moves. All right, hit save and I will see you in the next video.